please stand for the national colors. Attention, salute, pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. You may be seated. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor as principal to welcome you to the 2017 graduation ceremony of Chestatee High School. It is a blessing and a privilege for all of us to be here today to join in the celebration. It is without a doubt a special day, a day worthy of dignity and respect. These graduates have worked extremely hard. They've made numerous sacrifices to get to this point in their lives. Therefore, I humbly ask you to refrain from using air horns or other noise-making devices. If you have a small child, please know they are welcome with us today. However, if they begin to cry during the ceremony, I ask that you take them to our special children's room located in the lobby, so that our graduation can continue without disruption. An usher will be happy to assist you. I would like to extend a warm welcome to our parents, families, friends of graduates, Board of Education, administration, teachers, and support staff. The support from each of these groups has indeed made this day possible, and I'm thankful that you are here to celebrate with us. We have many special guests today. Please join me in recognizing them. The Honorable Lee Hawkins, State Representative. Mr. Nath Morris, Chairman, Hall County Board of Education. Mr. Craig Harrington, Vice Chair, Hall County Board of Education. Mr. Sam Chapman, Member, Hall County Board of Education. Mr. Brian Sloan, Member, Hall County Board of Education. Mr. Bill Thompson, Member, Hall County Board of Education. Mr. Neil Yarrington, Principal, Sardis Enrichment School. Ms. Jennifer Kogod, Principal, Chestatee Academy. And Mr. William Schofield, Superintendent, Hall County Schools. Also seated on the stage, Assistant Principal Christy Cantrell. Assistant Principal Ben Corley. Assistant Principal Matt Stowers. Counselor Judy Lambeth. Counselor Michelle White. Graduation Coach Lorraine Cronick. Graduation Coach Carrie Whitlow. And our Teacher of the Year, Ms. Jennifer Gibson. Teachers, on behalf of the graduates, I would like to give you a special thank you for investing in the lives and in the lives of all students. Oftentimes, you do not get to see the real difference you make. Today, you do. Thank you for following your hearts and answering the calling to teach. This world indeed is a better place because of you. Thank you. Graduates, I count it a blessing to be able to share this special day with each of you. Graduation day is indeed my favorite day of the year. I love seeing you as you celebrate this milestone in your life. In your honor, I am wearing my gown signed by each of you. I call this my gown of commitment. To all 244 of you walking today, I'm proud of each of you. You said you would, you believed you could, and indeed you did. Congratulations. As I sat down last week to put all of my words together to start making today's speech, my final chance to share with you my Monday morning words of wisdom. I guess it's Saturday morning words of wisdom today. So I went to my favorite place where I really go to think, my front porch. It was a perfect morning. The wind was blowing. I was in my rocking chair. I had a cup of coffee in my hand, ready to start penning my message. Just as I started to type, one of my daughters came outside. So I thought, I'll ask her for some advice. You see, she just graduated from Chestatee 2 years ago. So I said, Macy, do you remember what I said to your graduating class? What words of wisdom did I leave for you all? So I sat up tall, eyebrows raised, leaned forward, ready to hear what she remembered. And she said, nothing, Mama. I remember absolutely nothing. So I took a deep breath, and I thought, indeed, that might be true. So perhaps I need to make my speech shorter and relevant for you to remember any words that I share with you today. So that is indeed what I will do. So this morning, the title of my message goes like this: Success. True success is a four-letter word. Now, don't get nervous. Not any of those words that would be inappropriate to speak, but instead, quite the contrary. Today's words are love, L-O-V-E, and more, M-O-R-E. Two short words that, if followed, will lead to success. To be successful, you have to love more. You're probably wondering, Ms. Gerard, what in the world do you mean? I love my mom, I love my sister, my dad, my brother, my friends. I know how to love. I want to share with you a few thoughts this morning about love as an action. I want to talk to you about loving those who aren't easily loved. Those who are undeserving, those who can't do anything for you in return. I'm talking about loving selflessly, sacrificially, unconditionally, and maybe my favorite, unreservedly. To help us understand, I want us to examine each letter separately. L for life giver. O, put others first. V, value time. And finally, E, our theme this year, going the extra mile, demonstrating, and then some behavior. Let's start with L. To love more, you must be a life giver. That is, you must build others up rather than tearing them down. There are two types of people, bucket fillers and there are bucket dippers. All of us can be described as carrying an invisible dipper around with us. We also have invisible buckets. As we come in contact with others, we have the chance to fill their buckets by speaking life-giving words, that is, words of encouragement, words that heal, words that encourage. Occasionally, though, we will make the wrong choice and we will be a bucket dipper by speaking words that demean, slander, hurt, and wound. Our words are important. Quite literally, our words can give life or they can bring destruction. There are going to be times in your life when you disagree with others. It is human nature. Even then, my challenge to all of us, me first, is to use life-giving words. We can disagree without insulting, without ridiculing, and without hurting. I once heard the words we speak compared to a tube of toothpaste. So bear with me, visualize if you will, a plate with a tube of toothpaste all squirted out on that plate. And then me saying, can you get that toothpaste back in that tube? So it is with our words. Once they are spoken, just like the toothpaste, it is impossible to get them back in. Every day we have the choice to speak life-giving words or words of destruction. Let's challenge ourselves and commit to life-giving words to others. Let's now consider the word O for others. To love more, you simply have to put others before yourself. You must leverage your influence, your leadership, and your platform for the sake of others. Mother Teresa once said, if you can't feed 100, feed one. For you see, if I do my part, and Emma, and Jamie, and Austin do their part, it won't be long before collectively we're making a difference. I'm very proud of the movement we started at CHS. This year alone, CHS students have given over 7,000 community service hours. 7,000 hours. One of your fellow classmates, Heather Gorsuch, has given 300 herself this year alone. There are 14 of you wearing a community service medal, recognizing the platinum level of service that you achieved this year. Quite literally, because of your efforts, hungry families have food, homeless children have received clothes, and families battling cancer have gotten respite. You have given back, you've put others first, and I challenge you to continue to pour into others. The name Chestatee itself means light. Place of light. So I challenge you, take that tiny piece of light you've been given walking through those halls for the last 4 years. Leverage it to go beyond yourself and give back to others. The letter V in love. Value time. Value every moment. Time is a difficult concept to grasp. Sometimes it seems to stand still, while other times moving at lightning speed. It is counterintuitive. The days seem long, but the years short. How could that be? I challenge you to intentionally make a decision to enjoy every moment, whether it's at work or with your family. Savor the time. It will soon be gone. Rather than letting the busyness of life consume us, you know what I mean, thinking of something else when somebody's talking to you, getting to the end of the conversation and not even really knowing what that person said. If you've gone out to eat lately, if you'll look around, instead of conversations happening, sometimes phones are out. I challenge you, put those away. Be present, not just physically present in the room, but I mean wholly present with those you are with. I promise when I get that right, my relationships in life are right also. Imagine a bank gives you $86,400 each night. They deposit it into your account, with the only stipulation being the next morning, any money remaining is gone. I would imagine you would be like me, and I would try to spend every single cent. I would have shoes upon shoes, dresses upon dresses, if I received $86,400 to spend each day. But you see, we do. We each get 86,400 seconds every single day to spend. And with each new morning, we get a new 86,400 seconds to spend. We get to start over. We can bank none. So graduates, members of the audience, members on stage, my challenge is to spend wisely. Let's make a difference. Another truth about those 86,400 seconds is that some of them are going to be hard. Treasure the hard ones as well. For it's the hard ones that teach us the lessons, mold us into the person we were meant to be. I once heard someone say, turn your messes into messages. We indeed will all have messes. Let's turn those into messages. I was reminded of this recently when I had the pleasure of listening to some of our seniors, some of you sitting here, speak to our rising middle school students about though they had had challenges in high school, they have overcome them, and they are here today to walk across the stage, shake my hand, and get a diploma. Thanks, Erwin, Alex, and Jose, for reminding me of the truth that we all get a chance to start over, to reinvest those seconds into minutes that matter. Finally, I want to consider the last letter in love, the letter E, for extra. What does it mean to give extra? I think three words that we've talked about this year sum it up. The words are, and then some. These three words separate the good from the great, the ordinary from the extraordinary, and then some. People do what is required, and then some. They can be counted on in any situation, and then some. They carry their own load, and then some. They never give up on goals, even when met with challenges. No matter the obstacles, they persist. They overcome. We all know these types of people. Our very own alum, Jenny Arthur. She's an and then some person. Despite her circumstances of growing up in a large family with a single mother most of her life, she overcame. She worked hard. She practiced when there wasn't a called practice. She asked the coach to open the gym after hours. She is a result of her and then some behavior. We watched her this year compete in the Olympics because she indeed demonstrated and then some behavior. And then in the audience today, we have and then some people. Megan Dew competed recently for the state title in track, in which she got second place by a blink. Correction, a half a blink. If you can imagine the time it takes for your eye to touch the bottom of your face in one half a blink, that is the very minute distance that she missed the state title, but she didn't quit. Even rounding that last curve, if you can see the video, it gives me cold chills now, she dove across that line, not giving up. And then there's Matthew. He demonstrated and then some behavior when he worked through four rounds in sectionals, then four rounds in the state tournament without giving up to earn the state title and ring. And then Katie, two-time dramatic interpretation state champion, she too persisted. There are many others as well, too many for me to mention today. But if you look on the back of our program, you'll see all sorts of designations that make it clear that many of you understand and demonstrated and then some behavior. From our AP scholars to our Move On When Ready candidates, you all know what it means to give extra. Your class is graduating with over 238 college hours. Nicholas will get his diploma tonight with 14 college hours. Trevor with 11, Ben with 10. Graduates, continue your request to make a difference by going the extra mile. Remember what we say, there are no traffic jams on the extra mile. Ironically, in today's world, you will not find the four letters we consider today associated with success very often. Instead, you will find five-letter words, such as money, such as power. The irony, though, is that the two-letter words I've discussed, love and more, if you do those, they will lead to power and money. So graduates, you can have it all, and I expect that you will. In closing, as I recently attended my oldest daughter's UGA commencement ceremony, go Dawgs, proud of you, Tay. The commencement speaker there, Ernie Johnson, a well-known Turner Broadcasting sports commentator, talked about his special needs son. While his son cannot speak, he cannot verbalize words, Mr. Johnson says that one of his favorite things to do is to give his son this signal, which means, of course, I love you. He then has taught his son to look back at him, give him this, and move his index finger twice, which means, I love you too. Mr. Johnson, if you're watching today, I hope you don't mind if I steal this, but I want to add a twist. Graduates, instead of the index finger meaning you too, I want it to mean love more. So my final words of wisdom that I'm going to share with you today, my prayer for each of you this morning, graduates, is not words at all. It has no sound but speaks loud. I'd like to leave you with a signal and challenge you to live it loud. Thank you.
stars tonight. Oh, how they shine so bright. I gather them all so they perfectly align. While we gaze from far away and separately watch the day come rising across the horizon in our minds. But now I know my heart is strong.
Welcome and congratulations to my fellow seniors and to all of those who have carved us into the curious and perseverant individuals we are today. Parents, relatives, teachers, friends, and administrators, we can't believe this day has finally arrived. For months, we have been counting down the days, wishing the clocks would spin faster, eagerly envisioning what it would be like to finally be done. Now that the day is here, I wish it wasn't. This day means saying goodbye to teachers, friends, and so many others who have been our sources of wisdom, laughter, and who have shaped us permanently. I can never stand up here and pretend that high school was a montage of ease and perfection, where we never felt attacked, mistreated, or lost. I think we all felt this at some point, or at the very least, witnessed it in those around us. But the journey we embark on to conquer and even embrace these hardships paints the glorious image of what the future holds. As difficult as the end of a journey can be, whether it be the end of a thrilling book, an exhilarating friendship, or an entire chapter of our lives, endings are inevitable. But please realize that a lifetime of new beginnings awaits us. Beginnings are where we have the power to part ways with the hardships of the past, and where we have the power to hold on to the memories and the people who are such a big part of who we are and who we one day hope to become. We live in a world where we are constantly immersed in the fictitious and extraordinary characters of books, TV shows, and movies, where Harry Potter saves the wizarding world with the flick of a wand and a lightning bolt scar, where the Kardashians teach us a little bit something about family while they live in extravagant mansions and drive luxurious cars, and where a little clownfish could inspire us all by escaping the horrifying grasp of a brace-faced girl at the dentist. However, we also exist in a world dominated by slightly less cinematic, but amply more genuine and inspirational characters. Characters who have taken time out of this mess we call life to say words of encouragement to remind me that I'm not alone. Characters who have encouraged me to laugh without restraint, often to the point of tears. And characters who have been my pillars, my steps, and every other cliche metaphor signifying that I could not have done this alone. Lastly, I will never be able to find the words to fully express my gratitude towards my friends, family, and educators who have made countless sacrifices to provide me with opportunities to succeed. Thank you to all of my teachers who have truly left a mark on my life. Thank you to my family for teaching me strength and compassion and showing me unconditional love. And thank you to my friends for allowing me to be myself when I felt out of place. And lastly, thank you to Bert for supporting me throughout my lowest points. I want everyone to take at least one simple point from this speech. No matter who we are today, what we have faced, or where we have come from, we are something. Something riveting, consequential, and something worthwhile. And with that something, we each face a world before us. A world we should explore to the fullest extent. A world that we should try to shape and be shaped by. No matter what journey we embark on, there's one universal truth that applies to each and every one of us. Happiness is the ultimate goal we should each strive for. Don't put off being happy. Don't wait for it to find you. Embrace the little moments as they come. After all, the greatest things in life seem to come in the smallest packages. I'm deeply thankful that I was given the honor to stand before you all as your salutatorian and say a little something about what the past 4 years have meant to me. I sincerely hope you all find the purest and most raw form of joy in whatever path you choose. Congratulations to you all. I am so indescribably proud to be part of the class of 2017. And now, on to my best friend, the person who has been with me through it all, your valedictorian, Amanda Norris.
Hello, class of 2017, parents, friends, faculty. For those who don't know me, I'm sorry, you missed out. No, but before I get started, I'd like to note that I honestly have no idea why I'm up here to give you advice about the future, because I'm in no way qualified to do so. Yes, I have an idea about my future, but I'm just as, or maybe even more confused than you. Plus, I'm just extremely effective at using Spark Notes. Just kidding, Miss White, I love the Scarlet Letter. Five stars, 10 out of 10. No, but I think this does give awareness to a quote my eighth grade teacher, Miss Mole, once stated, work smarter, not harder. You've always heard the sayings about putting 110% into everything you do, but I say put 110% into the things that you're passionate about, whether that be nursing, business, teaching, or anything else. Throughout these past 4 years, we've experienced immense amounts of stress. We've had to put our all into everything we do, including the things we have zero interest in. From this day on, chase your happiness, focus on pursuing your dreams, and never settle for anything less, because there will be a time when we can't, and there's nothing worse than regret. For a lot of us, worry is our biggest enemy, but when you think about it, worrying does absolutely nothing to help. Worrying won't get you out of that job interview, or that audition, or even that huge speech you have to give at graduation. Yeah, don't judge me. But honestly, there is no use in worrying about things that are inevitable. And with that, I think it's important to focus on the little things or the things that happen along the way. I have spent the last 4 years, years chasing the number one spot. I've been so consumed with the big picture with this one day, but if someone were to ask what was the best day or best thing about my high school career, it wouldn't be getting the GPA. It would be finding my purpose, my meaning, or even the people who often remind me of why I'm here today, my friends. However, I do think that a close second would be the day Greer got his ponytail cut off because he had to walk around for two periods with a bob cut, and that was truly iconic. We as a class were presented with many challenges and obstacles that we had to overcome during these last 4 years of high school. We had to endure the harsh and excruciating singing of Mr. Sheeman. We have basked in the glory that is Miss Lott's Crocs. We have tap danced on Miss Matthews' last nerves, but only because we love you. And we have been forced to watch corgi videos in Mr. Davis's class. And we were all victim to Coach Webster and his megaphone in the hallway. We've all seen Mr. Corley on the sidelines of a football or basketball game with the other administrators making sure he doesn't get kicked out. And we've all witnessed Mr. Skogman sniff Expo markers. But above all, we have learned to avoid and dodge every administrator to the best of our abilities due to our ID badges, which reminds me. For a second there, I wasn't safe. My sincerest apologies. I just don't know what we're going to do in the real world because no one's going to know us, you know, because we don't have our ID badges. Our odds of survival are slim. Despite these odds, we still have managed to graduate, and I think that deserves a round of applause. We've done it. We've learned to find to the nearest tenth of a foot the length of a shadow cast by a 13-foot lamppost when the angle of elevation of the sun is 58 degrees. Thank God we won't need to know how to file taxes or correctly manage our finances. Learning such a thing would have been a tremendous waste of time. But on a serious note, I would like to thank all the people in my life who have given me their unconditional love and support. Without it, I would not be here giving you this horridly long and boring speech. I owe everything to the people who put their time into making me who I am today, and I cannot be more grateful. More importantly, I would love to give a special thanks to my partner in crime, Cody Cagle. I wouldn't have wanted anyone else by my side on this day. However, you will live by this one thing. If all else fails, C's get degrees. But seriously, all of you, regardless of your class rank, deserve to be here. Congratulations, class of 2017. And in the legendary words of Elle Woods, we did it. You guys have an amazing... You guys have an amazing rest of the day, and once again, thank you.
To summarize, love, and love well. To summarize, each and every one of you are special. Whether you believe it or not, you're special. And finally, whatever you do, do it with all your might. Good morning, War Eagles. That was pretty good, I have to tell you. Out of six graduations so far, that's the best first one. But I know War Eagles can do even better. Good morning, War Eagles. Fantastic. Board of Education members, special guests, administration, faculty, family, friends, community members, I know that you're not standing where I am right now and you don't have the ability to visualize what I can see, but would you agree with me that this class of 2017 is absolutely, positively beautiful? Congratulations. And also, before I begin, would you just take a moment with me to thank Pastor Franklin and his incredible team here at Free Chapel, who year after year open up this facility for us. You know, graduates, 17 years I've been doing this superintendent thing, and I've lost count, but it's somewhere between 80 and 90 graduations. And this morning I've got some bad news and some good news and some bad news for you. The bad news is that your diplomas really aren't real until I do something called conferring them. And that's a fancy word that just tells your Board of Education that you've done everything that you're supposed to do as far as the state of Georgia and your Hall County Board of Education are concerned. The good news is that in just a few minutes we're going to do that. But the bad news is that in 80-some graduations, I've never missed an opportunity to make you sit through just one last high school lesson before you get your diplomas. I'm sorry. Now, early on when I would do this, you know, I'd always use the word advice. I want to give you some advice. I want to give you all some advice and some counsel. And then, you know, over time I was reminded of the words of Thoreau. And Thoreau said, never take the advice of an old guy, because the only advice he's going to give you is in areas in which he's failed. And there's a lot of truth in that. I've failed in so many ways. And the other thing that I've learned as a little more gray has come into the hair is that unsought advice, advice that you give people that they haven't asked for, just doesn't have much meaning. And there's an awful lot of advice given every day on this planet that doesn't mean much of anything to anyone. So over the last several years, I've moved away from advice, and I've decided instead that the last lesson that I would leave you with as you graduate from high school would not be bits of advice, but it would instead be kernels of truth. There's a huge difference, class of 2017, between advice and truth. It's about 2,000 years ago that Pilate asked that famous question when he said, what is truth? Truth are those things that don't change. They're timeless. They go on. What was true in the year 1950 is also true in 2017. It was true 1,000 years ago, and it'll be true 1,000 years from now. Truth. I want to ask you a question before I challenge you with three truths this morning. And that question is, do you believe that the creator of this universe made each and every one of the 5 or 6 billion people incredibly uniquely and with special gifts that you and only you have? It really, yeah, that's something to celebrate. And it really doesn't matter whether you believe that or not, but it's truth. And let's just be honest. I mean, ever since kindergarten, we'd sit around and we'd watch somebody color next to us, and we'd start to learn pretty quick whether or not we were very good at coloring. I was not. And it's pretty hard to copy at coloring. Some of you are gifted artists, as we just saw. Oh my goodness, some of you are gifted musicians. How about another round of applause for that group? I've been to some of your drama productions, and many of you are gifted in terms of drama. Some of you are gifted with interpersonal skills. You get around people and they just kind of feel at home, like they know you, that they can trust you, they can talk with you. Others of you are gifted writers. Some of you are gifted at building stuff. It just makes sense to you and you can put things together. But make no mistake, each and every one of you has unique and incredible gifts. But you know, the greatest gift that I believe each and every one of us has been given is this gift that gives us the ability to choose. We can make our own choices in life. And whether you live to be 40 or 70 or 90 or 103, as you look back at your life, in many ways you will rate it based on a number of the choices that you've made. So this morning, as you get ready to graduate, I want to leave you and challenge you over the coming weeks to purpose in your heart to make three choices. Ms. Gerard talked about one of them. We'll get to that last because it is my favorite. But the first choice I want to challenge you to make, class of 2017, I want to challenge you to choose truth over a false life. You know, I was recently reading a study and it really bothered me because the study suggested that the average American, lies between 100 and 200 times a day. A day. Now, when I first read that headline, I said, well, I'm kind of an average American. I don't lie 100 or 200 times a day. Those guys probably do. And next year, you're going to say, hey, you remember that guy that used to be the superintendent of Hall County School District? But then I went on and I read the article. And please be aware, graduates of 2017, there's a number of different ways that we can lie. We can live life in such a way that we lie with our words. That's the obvious one. But we can also lie with our lack of words. We can lie with our gestures. We can lie by living our lives in such a way that they really don't match up with who we've led everybody else to believe that we are. You know, a truth, and you just get this one for nothing, is that there's no perfect people sitting in this auditorium. And there are no perfect people in your community. So while you may never be able to live that life of perfect truth, it is never too late, nor in your cases is it ever too early to choose a path of truth. I challenge you, graduates, to choose truth over falsehood. You know, we've had people talking tonight about the fact that some of you are going to spend your lives and you're going to put your hands into the work of being a nurse or being a teacher or being an engineer, going into the armed services, or you're going to be a law enforcement, or you're going to be a fireman, or you're going to stay at home and you're going to raise beautiful children. But let me suggest to you that if you don't choose truth, that whatever else you choose, when you lay your head on your pillow at night, you will not be able to get a very sound night's sleep. But if you do choose truth, you'll wake up that next morning, not only after having had a good night's sleep, but there'll be a sparkle in your eye and there'll be a snap in your step. Choose truth. The second choice I'd challenge you to make, and your salutatorian and valedictorian both alluded to this, choose your own path. You know, ever since you were little boys and girls, and can't call you boys and girls anymore, you're men and women. But ever since you were little boys and girls, some of us that love you the most have told you a little lie. I guess it's one of those 200 a day. And the lie goes something like this: great minds think alike. Let me suggest to you that nothing could be further from the truth. The great minds of history, I suspect the great minds that have influenced you in your lives have been those individuals who've been willing to go against the herd, to make decisions against the grain, to stand up for those things that sometimes are unpopular, and to dream and to pursue those things that many people would say are impossible. You have the ability, graduating class of 2017, to choose your own path. And with absolutely, positively no disrespect to parents or grandparents or individuals who love you, let me suggest that wise individuals always seek counsel. I would hope you're going to older and wiser people that love you and saying, what do you see in my character? What do you see in me? Give me some ideas about some things that you see in me as I choose a path as I move forward. But ultimately, let nobody else choose your path. It is your path to walk. I remember ever since I was a little kid, I've been around loving adults that have said, this kid's going to be a nurse, and this kid's going to be a mechanic, and oh, I can see it already. This kid's going to be an attorney. And there's nothing wrong with getting counsel from others. But let me beg you to choose your own path. You know, one of the things, whether you know it or not, I think, Ms. Gerard, you said there's about 245 of these beautiful young people here today, is that one of the definitions that you've already got in your mind, whether you know it or not, is going to drive you in terms of what path that you choose. And the definition in the word that I'm talking about is success. If I passed out 245 index cards and I said, here's your last assignment, give me four sentences that describe what it means to be successful, I would get 245 different definitions. And I believe if we're really honest with each other, a lot of your definitions, you've never really thought a whole lot about it. Can I suggest to you that you ought to take some time in your quietest space to come up with your own definition of success? Because what you define as success is going to drive what you do in terms of the friends that you make, the education that you pursue, the individual that you choose to marry or not to marry, the type of an occupation that you choose, how you spend your time, how you spend your resources, what you do in your free time. Whatever you define as success will drive you on making that choice of choosing your own path. You know, there's no perfect definition of success. It'd be hard to say that someone's definition is better than everybody else's. But over the years, a definition of success that I've grown to love and hold dear to my heart is what Ralph Waldo Emerson said. And Emerson said, ah, success. Success is to laugh often and much. It's to win the respect of intelligent people and the affection of children. It's to earn the appreciation of your honest critics, and it's to endure the betrayal of your false friends. It's to appreciate beauty. It's to see the best in others. And it's to strive to leave this world a better place, whether that's with a healthy child, by redeeming a social condition, or even just planting an awful nice garden patch. But graduates, Emerson said this. He said, true success will be measured at the end of every day when you ask the question, has at least one person breathed easier today because you have lived? If the answer is yes, you are a success. So I challenge you, choose truth over falsehood. Do it intentionally. I challenge you to seek counsel, but please choose your own path. And the final challenge I give you just summarizes what Ms. Gerard already said so beautifully to you. Let me challenge you to choose love. Choose love. You know, before the graduation, I asked some of your parents, and I'm not going to embarrass them by telling them who they are. I said, what are you feeling right now? Believe me, the focus today and the focus for these days that surround today is you. But keep in mind, those people that love you, a number of them are experiencing some pretty strong emotions right now. And as I asked some of your parents, what are you feeling today? I got answers like, sad. No, happy. No, I'm sad. Okay, I'm both. My baby's growing up. They're going 3.5 hours away to school. They're going 4 hours away to some academy. They're going 2 hours away. My baby is growing up. Many were winsome. It just is an unbelievable emotion, having graduated two of my three children already of my own, that I would ask you to be sensitive and to be loving to those folks in your home. It's a big day for you and for them. But back to choosing love. When I challenge you to choose love, I don't mean the love that's easy. The folks who love you first, that's the easy love. And they certainly deserve your love. And they deserve your respect. And they deserve your thanks for what they've done for you. People who treat you well, in general, they're pretty easy to love. That's another kind of fairly easy love. People who do things that in some way benefit you, I find it pretty easy to love those kind of individuals. But can I suggest to you that the depth of a nation or of an organization or of a family or of an individual can truly be found in your willingness to love those who are absolutely unlovable, who have absolutely positively nothing to give you in return? The least of these are brethren. That is where you will find your value. That is where you will develop your character. Young people, I have so many hopes and prayers for you and where you go from here, but let me suggest to you that one of them I hope your generation will lead us forward with is while you make some choices, and you make some choices to do things like pursuing truth and choosing your own path and choosing to love even those who are unlovable, that you also are willing at times to stand up, and you never won't know when these moments are coming, and just do the right thing. To do the right thing even when the entire herd seems to be going the other direction. To do the right thing even when it would be easy to do the wrong thing, but there's something in the pit of your heart that says, this isn't right, I should make a different decision. That takes courage. That takes a real war eagle. And can I suggest that if you will make those decisions and do those things that are good and pure and honorable and praiseworthy and noble and right, you will live that life worth living. We are so proud of you. Congratulations, class of 2017.
Diplomas. Mr. Chairman, Board of Education, in accordance with the regulations and the policies of your Hall County Board of Education and the laws of the state of Georgia, and on behalf of your Board of Education and myself, I hereby declare that these members of the class of 2017 have met all requirements and are therefore eligible to be designated as graduates of the best high school in America, Chestatee High School. Congratulations.
Amanda Rachel Norris, valedictorian. Cody Lee Cagle, salutatorian. Mary Elizabeth Barnett, third honor graduate. Hannah Kate Beeman. Nicholas Kyle Beasley. McKinley Raymond Benson. Sarah Catherine Berliner. Alex Lee Correa. Trevor Henry Crow. Rebecca May Eddins. Carly Miranda English. Austin Robert Jean. Layla Mahayalani Hodge. Daniel James Holland. Hannah Claire Holland. Caitlin Nicole Ivy. Baron Charles King. Madeline Chloe Knickel. Kara Grace Leverett. Jamie Seymour Mancuso. Maria Guadalupe Marquez Garcia. Ivan Alexander Martin. Wesley Paul Nicholson. Ashley Tan Pham. Nicholas Mark Poole. Jordan Kaylee Pruitt. Alberto Antonio Reynaud. Catherine Michelle Ryersey. Allison Nicole Sheeman. Heather Suzanne Schull. Cage Jackson Sennett. Ireland Kerwin Stackhouse. Amber Marie Strickland. Lauren Ashley Wilbanks. Alyssa Megan Yark. Anna Nicole Abercrombie. Jocelyn Lee Kira Akers. Bertha Alejo Cruz. Emily Alvarado. Benjamin Linton Andrew. Arnold Alejandro Aragon Chavez. Elias Arzati. Lizeth Arzati. Juana Alicia Baca. Jennifer Vianney Banda. Jacob William Barger. Lizeth Barrientos. Nicholas William Beard. Dondria Ajane Bell. Evie Mae Bennett. Lauren Michelle Bennett. Jessica Ann Berliner. Jason Holt Begeverges. Cody Stephen Blackwell. Jose Adolfo Bonilla. Kurt Anthony Boyd. Nicholas Garrett Brackett. Summer Neona Brackett. Stephanie Adelie Brissino. Alex Christopher Britt. Dawson Montana Brock. Lucas Vernon Brown. Morgan Tyler Bryant. Julissa Berciaga. Nina Paige Burgess. Nayeli Cabral. Dawson Bailey Camp. Austin Taylor Cash. Yohairo Castaneda. Leticia Castillo. Natalia Asia Castillo. Brittany Nicole Cates. Evan Jonathan Catron. Jonathan Caudillo. Luis Adrian Ceballos. Salvador Daniel Chavez. Chase Douglas Bo Cheek. Austin Sean Cheshire. Haley Maxine Cole. Jose Jesus Contreras. Caitlin Lucia Mayer. Andrea Corona. Haley Nicole Coyle. Janelle Selena Cruz. Kevin Cruz. Moses Cuevas. Raven Nicole Davenport. Christian Fabian De La Torre. Amanda Joe Dees. Megan Lee Dew. Ethan Brian Dixon. Emma Carol Dollyhigh. Maria Alejandra Dominguez Cedillo. Aaliyah Rose Douglas. Maritza Duarte. Cade Ryan Dunn. Jade Brianna Dupree. Victoria Summer Eddy. Bethany Ray English. Jonathan Espinoza Mendoza. Zachariah Dade Etter. Josue Farrell Salgado. Daisy Flores De La Cruz. Christian James Floyd. William Gregory Fraser. Andre Fratilla. Andrew Blake Gaddis. Robert Jordan Galloway. Jenna Rose Gowiran. Yvonne Garcia. Kyle Avery Garrett. Lizeth Godinez Sanchez. Ashley Page Go. Andreas Gonzalez Jr. Christian Antonio Gonzalez. Stephanie Gonzalez. Skylar Mark Gooch. Heather Nicole Gorisek. Aiden Douglas Graham. Nicholas Brian Gray. Keaton Green. Ezekiel Guardiola. Bailey Olivia Hoff. Heather Marie Hampton. Nero Mushan Hawks. Aramis Angelin Hernandez. Elias Herrera Cardiel. Yvette Natividad Herrera Kofer. Ashley Faith Hinesley. Savannah Lee Holland. Natalie Kate Howington. Logan Corey Hudson. Sean Matthew Eyrick. Gabriella Hymus. Blakely Thomas Jarrett, Thompson Jarrett. Johanna Lissette Jimenez. Brianna Marie Johnson. Myra Alejandra Juarez. Jacob Levi Kennedy. Morgan Allie Kidd. Annalise Nicole Corner. Brooklyn Nicole Kogod. Nicholas James Leonos. Cameron Trey Lewis. Emerald Nebraska Star Lingerfelt. Bryce Elizabeth Lipscomb. Miguel Angel Lugo. Cody Michael Luke. Jesus Gilberto Luna. Olivia Kendall Lyons. Arisbel Maldonado. Carlos Eduardo Marin. Zachary Alec Martin. Andreas Martinez Jr. John Martinez. Nathaniel Mana M. Martinez. Norma Clara Martinez. Giovanni Martinez Romero. Carter James McCaleb. Matthew Ryan McClellan. Jennifer Grace McConnell. Christian Scott McKenzie. Luis Medina Jr. Juan Mejia. Kellen Gabriela Mejia. William Jefferson Mendez. Daisy Mendoza. Alicio Mendoza Ponce. Donald Jonathan Milford. Austin Dale Miller. Sarah Elizabeth Miller. Kingston Noheya Morris. Tyler Chance Morrison. Oscar Mosqueda. Eddie Ramirez. Jimmy Wynn. Austin Chase Nicholson. Jonathan Braxton Nicholson. George Nunez. Zachary Ryan Odell. Daisy Olivas. Juan Manuel Orduno Jr. Eric Ortiz Garcia. Nader Mohammed Osman. Miguel Patino Jr. Sergio Obdulio Pineda Cortez. Tyler Scott Perkin. Desiree Lynn Pierce. Erica Pisano Garcia. Linda Itzel Ponce. Brooklyn Hope Popham. Jake Joseph Ray Peronsky. Yasmin Lizette Ramos. Edgar Eduardo Ramos Lopez. Leela Marissa Razor. Briseida De Jesus Rebelar. Tatiana Lissette Rivas. Eduardo Rivera Garcia. Katie Danielle Roberts. Angel Rodriguez. Baltazar Uriel Rodriguez Lopez. Alexander Romero Gomez. Isabel Cristina Rocio. Juan Diego Rocio. Joel Salcido Salazar. Daniel Sanchez Ribellido. Austin Douglas Sargent. Sophia Alyssa Savash. Jose Isaiah Segovia. Michael Dion Shaw. Christy Renee Sherrill. Amber Lee Sinkfeld. Courtney Cherie Smith. Katie Kendra Sosby. Anna Catherine Souther. Emma Angeline Spurgeon. Kelsey Alyssa Stroud. Michael David Tinsley. Lyric Tisdale. Charlie James Turner. Jose Fidel Uribe Jr. Eric Jonathan Vargas. Geraldine Vargas. Jose Alberto Vargas. Giovanni Vargas Dominguez. Maria Fernanda Vasquez Godinez. Andrew Michael Veal. Rosario Ventura. Guadalupe Vera. Erwin Augustin Verduzco. Ubitsy Vilches. Juan Carlos Villegas. Josh Israel Viveros. Brandon Lee Wallace. Haley Alexis Webb. Caitlin Marie Williams. Allison Nicole Sheeman. Heather Suzanne Schull. Cage Jackson Sennett. Ireland Kerwin Stackhouse. Amber Marie Strickland. Lauren Ashley Wilbanks. Alyssa Megan York. Anna Nicole Abercrombie. Jocelyn Lee Kira Akers. Bertha Alejo Cruz. Emily Alvarado. Benjamin Linton Andrew. Arnold Alejandro Aragon Chavez. Elias Arzati. Lizeth Arzati. Juana Alicia Baca. Jennifer Vianney Banda. Jacob William Barger. Lizeth Barrientos. Nicholas William Beard. Dondria Ajane Bell. Evie Mae Bennett. Lauren Michelle Bennett. Jessica Ann Berliner. Jason Holt Begeverges. Cody Stephen Blackwell. Jose Adolfo Bonilla. Kurt Anthony Boyd. Nicholas Garrett Brackett. Summer Neona Brackett. Stephanie Adelie Brusino. Alex Christopher Britt. Dawson Montana Brock. Lucas Vernon Brown. Morgan Tyler Bryant. Julissa Berciaga. Nina Paige Burgess. Nayeli Cabral. Dawson Bailey Camp. Austin Taylor Cash. Yohairo Castaneda. Leticia Castillo. Natalia Asia Castillo. Brittany Nicole Cates. Evan Jonathan Catron. Jonathan Caudillo. Luis Adrian Ceballos. Salvador Daniel Chavez. Chase Douglas Bo Cheek. Austin Sean Cheshire. Haley Maxine Cole. Jose Jesus Contreras. Caitlin Lucia Mayer. Andrea Corona. Haley Nicole Coyle. Janelle Selena Cruz. Kevin Cruz. Moses Cuevas. Raven Nicole Davenport. Christian Fabian De La Torre. Amanda Jo Dees. Megan Lee Dew. Ethan Brian Dixon. Emma Carol Dollyhigh. Maria Alejandra Dominguez Cedillo. Aaliyah Rose Douglas. Maritza Duarte. Cade Ryan Dunn. Jade Brianna Dupree. Victoria Summer Eddy. Bethany Ray English. Jonathan Espinoza Mendoza. Zachariah Dade Etter. Josue Farrell Salgado. Daisy Flores de la Cruz. Christian James Floyd. William Gregory Fraser. Andre Fratilla. Andrew Blake Gaddis. Robert Jordan Galloway. Jenna Rose Gowiran. Yvonne Garcia. Kyle Avery Garrett. Lizeth Godinez Sanchez. Ashley Page Goh. Andreas Gonzalez Jr. Christian Antonio Gonzalez. Stephanie Gonzalez. Skylar Mark Gooch. Heather Nicole Gorisek. Aiden Douglas Graham. Nicholas Brian Gray. Keaton Green. Ezekiel Guardiola. Bailey Olivia Hoff. Heather Marie Hampton. Nero Mushan Hawks. Aramis Angelin Hernandez. Elias Herrera Cardiel. Yvette Natividad Herrera Kofer. Ashley Faith Hinesley. Savannah Lee Holland. Natalie Kate Howington. Logan Corey Hudson. Sean Matthew Irick. Gabriella Hymus. Blakely Thomas Jarrett, Thompson Jarrett. Johanna Lissette Jimenez. Brianna Marie Johnson. Myra Alejandra Juarez. Jacob Levi Kennedy. Morgan Allie Kidd. Annalise Nicole Corner. Brooklyn Nicole Kogod. Nicholas James Lianos. Cameron Trey Lewis. Emerald Nebraska Star Lingerfelt. Bryce Elizabeth Lipscomb. Miguel Angel Lugo. Cody Michael Luke. Jesus Gilberto Luna. Olivia Kendall Lyons. Arisbel Maldonado. Carlos Eduardo Marin. Zachary Alec Martin. Andreas Martinez Jr. John Martinez. Nathaniel Mana M. Martinez. Norma Clara Martinez. Giovanni Martinez Romero. Carter James McCaleb. Matthew Ryan McClellan. Jennifer Grace McConnell. Christian Scott McKenzie. Luis Medina Jr. Juan Mejia. Kellen Gabriela Mejia. William Jefferson Mendez. Daisy Mendoza. Alicio Mendoza Ponce. Donald Jonathan Milford. Austin Dale Miller. Sarah Elizabeth Miller. Kingston Noheya Morris. Tyler Chance Morrison. Oscar Mosqueda. Eddie Ramirez. Jimmy Wynn. Austin Chase Nicholson. Jonathan Braxton Nicholson. George Nunez. Zachary Ryan Odell. Daisy Olivas. Juan Manuel Orduno Jr. Eric Ortiz Garcia. Nader Mohammed Osman. Miguel Patino Jr. Sergio Obdulio Pineda Cortez. Tyler Scott Perkin. Desiree Lynn Pierce. Erica Pisano Garcia. Linda Itzel Ponce. Brooklyn Hope Popham. Jake Joseph Ray Peronsky. Yasmin Lizette Ramos. Edgar Eduardo Ramos Lopez. Leela Marissa Razor. Briseida De Jesus Rebelar. Tatiana Lissette Rivas. Eduardo Rivera Garcia. Katie Danielle Roberts. Angel Rodriguez. Baltazar Uriel Rodriguez Lopez. Alexander Romero Gomez. Isabel Cristina Rocio. Juan Diego Rocio. Joel Salcido Salazar. Daniel Sanchez Ribeiro. Austin Douglas Sargent. Sophia Alyssa Savash. Jose Isaias Segovia. Michael Dion Shaw. Christy Renee Sherrill. Amber Lee Sinkfeld. Courtney Cherie Smith. Katie Kendra Sosby. Anna Catherine Souther. Emma Angeline Spurgeon. Kelsey Alyssa Stroud. Michael David Tinsley. Lyric Tisdale. Charlie James Turner. Jose Fidel Uribe Jr. Eric Jonathan Vargas. Geraldine Vargas. Jose Alberto Vargas. Giovanni Vargas Dominguez. Maria Fernanda Vasquez Godinez. Andrew Michael Veal. Rosario Ventura. Guadalupe Vera. Erwin Augustin Verduzco. Ubitsy Vilches. Juan Carlos Villegas. Josh Israel Viveros. Brandon Lee Wallace. Haley Alexis Webb. Caitlin Marie Williams. Michael Harold Williams. Benjamin Scott Wortman. Roberto Yanez. Sergio Antonio Yibra. Kelsey Janelli Zambrano. Brenda Abigail Zamora Preciado. Daniel Luke Zimmer. Congratulations, class of 2017. At this time, no microphone. Please stand for the singing of the alma mater.
Our
Seniors, we will leave this building today as something we've never been before, high school graduates. The turning of our tassels signifies our transition from high school students to high school graduates. So without further ado, please join me in moving our tassels from the right to the left as official graduates of Chestatee High School. As we close our ceremonies, graduates, let me remind you of your heritage. As a graduate of CHS, you are forever committed to the sea, forever a war eagle. Character, courage, commitment, that's who we are, that's what we do. As you enter the next phase of your life, may you face every situation with the strength of the war eagle and soar. Congratulations, class of 2017. Thank you.